give God all the glory. We bless the name of the Lord. We magnify his wonderful name. Our God is good. Our God is good. Somebody out there.
All the time.
Our God is good. We give you glory, Lord. As we honor you. We give you glory, Lord. As we honor you, you are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. Father in heaven, indeed, Lord, a wonderful God. What a great Father you are, King of kings and the Lord of lords. Thank you, Most High, for this last week. Thank you, Eternal Rock of Ages, King of kings and the Lord of lords, for preserving all of us. Thank you, Lord Almighty, for another day in your presence. Your word says, in your presence there is fullness of joy, and at your right hand side there are pleasures forevermore. King of kings and the Lord of lords, we have gathered, Lord Almighty, at your feet today, Lord, to dine with you. King of kings and the Lord of lords, Eternal Rock of Ages, feed us, Lord Almighty, today, Lord Almighty, with the abundance of your blessing. Father, Lord God, satisfy our thirsting today. Satisfy our hunger today with your words. In the name of Jesus. We want to also just thank you, Lord Almighty, for everything you have been doing. Your protection, Lord Almighty. Your words, Lord, that have never failed. Father, in heaven, your healing power. We are grateful, King of kings and the Lord of lords, because, Lord, we have not diminished in number. Father, in heaven, King of glory, Lord of lords, we thank you. Mighty God, accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Heavenly Lord, Eternal Rock of Ages, the next few minutes, you commit into your hands. Father, in heaven, King of glory, Lord of lords, speak to us, Lord Almighty. King of glory, Lord of lords, please, Lord Almighty, this morning, speak to us, Eternal Rock of Ages. Let us hear clearly from the throne of grace. Thank you, Most High, for answers to our prayers. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This morning, by the grace of God, we are going to be encouraging ourselves with the word of God. We are going to be talking about the spirit of fear. The spirit of fear. We're going to read our Bible reading this morning. It is from 2 Timothy. We're going to read 2 Timothy chapter 1. We're going to read verses 6 and 7. 2 Timothy 1. We're going to read verses 6 and 7. Therefore, I remind you to stir up the gift of God which is in you through the laying on of my hands. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. May the Lord bless the reading of his holy words in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. That Bible passage that we have just read is a letter from Paul to Timothy. Paul was writing Timothy at this time. I'm guessing that Paul must have been exhibiting some fear. That particular time, even the writer of that Bible passage, the writer of that letter himself, Paul was in prison. So that was the time at the height of persecution of Christians by the Roman Empire. And Timothy, like a whole lot of us right now, must have been exhibiting some fear, some doubt, what is happening? Why does it seem like we have cried to God and it seems like he's not answering us? What fear do we have? Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Some of us is not even this COVID-19, is not the coronavirus. Some of us have fears that what is tomorrow going to be like? what is in store for us tomorrow. We have the fear of where are we going to get the same, the next meal rather. Where are we going to get in the next meal from? Some of us, the fear of, am I going to be healed from this disease? Am I going to be healed from this that I'm going through? Some of us, it is a fear of maybe our children that are not doing well. What is going to happen to this child? Perhaps some of us, the fear is what is going on in our marriage. My prayer to you this morning, my prayer for you is that God himself will be with you in the name of Jesus, that it will be your strong tower in the mighty name of Jesus. Before we go on, I just want to let you know that when we are talking about we are encouraging people not to be fearful. We are not saying just abandon all caution. We are not saying just be reckless. We are not saying go to the zoo in Philadelphia and go and jump into the lion's cage there. That is not what we are talking about. We are talking about the type of fear that makes a man not achieve what the Lord wants that man to achieve in life. The type of fear that sometimes irrational. Sometimes there are rational fears, but when you know who is in you, when you trust who is in you, when you have faith in who is in you, those fears should not dominate your life. And that is what we are talking about. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What is fear itself? I remember in school we learned a little about what fear is. I won't go into technical times this morning. But what happens is your eyes see something or you hear something fearful, something that you're afraid of, and send signals to your brain. And your brain also sends signals to some other parts of your body. Some chemicals are released. Those chemicals make your heart to beat faster. Makes your breathing to go faster. When they go to your muscles, your muscles react to those chemicals. Physiology calls it flight or fight. Thank you. My daughter is reminding me here. Praise the name of the Lord. It's called the flight or fight. So what your body has done is to prepare you to either fight whatever has caused the stimulus. Whatever it is that has caused you to react, it has caused your body to get prepared to fight that thing or to run away from that thing. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But what we are talking about this morning is irrational or extreme fear. Also sometimes leads to phobia. Irrational or extreme. Fear that is persistent and will negatively impact the life, the everyday living of a child of God. That type of fear is from the devil. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The first time something close to fear was mentioned in the Bible was when Adam, and this is why I believe that fear, the type of fear that we are talking about this morning, is not of God. The first time it was mentioned in the Bible was when Adam and Eve sinned. And the Bible says they were afraid and they hid themselves from God. Genesis chapter 3, verse 10. Adam said, I heard the sound of you in the garden. I heard the sound of you in the garden. He was talking to God, yeah? And I was afraid, because I was naked, so I hid myself. So sin brought fear. God did not create this type of fear that we are talking about. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
There's actually good fear and there is bad fear. The spirit of fear, like every other spirit, could either come from God or from the devil. There's a spirit of fear that is mentioned in the book of Isaiah. Prophet Isaiah mentioned the type of fear, the spirit of fear. In Isaiah chapter 11, we can read from verse 1 to 3. It is called the spirit of the fear of the Lord. The spirit of the fear of the Lord. Let's read it quickly. Isaiah 11, 1 to 3. There shall come forth a rod from the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him. The spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him. The spirit of wisdom and understanding. The spirit of counsel and might. The spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. So there is a spirit of the fear, or there is a spirit of fear that is called the spirit of fear of the Lord that comes from the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This one that is mentioned by the prophet Isaiah is a reverential fear. It's a fear that comes from reverence. It's not a fear that comes from being afraid. It's a fear that keeps one from sinning. This type of fear keeps you from sinning. It's the type of fear that is mentioned in Proverbs chapter 8, verse 13. Proverbs 8, 13 says, the fear of the Lord is hatred of evil. The fear of the Lord is hatred of evil. The spirit of fear that we are going to deal about, that we are going to be dealing about, that we are going to be talking about this morning, is the one that comes from the devil. Fear that comes from being afraid. Fear that comes from being oppressed. Fear that originates from the devil. I pray for as many as are fearful this morning, that Christ the Savior will deliver each and every one in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's go back to that Bible passage again, 2 Timothy chapter 1. We're going to just concentrate on verse 7. 2 Timothy chapter 1. We're going to just concentrate on verse 7. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. God has not given us a spirit of fear. Fear as a spirit. Fear as a spirit. Romans 8, 15 says, I'll just paraphrase. Romans 8, 15, you did not receive the spirit of bondage again to fear. Fear opens the door for all other manifestation of evil spirit. Fear opens the door. Let me repeat that again. Fear opens the door for every other manifestation of the evil spirit. Some of the manifestation of evil spirit mentioned in the Bible, you can link them to the spirit of fear. For example, it is only fear that will make a man to seek for what the Bible calls familiar spirits. The Bible several times talk about people seeking familiar spirit or people having familiar spirit. Familiar spirit is the spirit that is in wizards, that are in herbalists, that are in witches. It is only fear. The fear that I don't know what this man is thinking about me. I don't know the evil that this man is planning for me, that makes people sick. No person in his right sense will go and seek a herbalist, will go to a wizard. It is the fear that is in that man. It is the fear of what that person will do that leads people to seek those people. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Bible talks about spirit of jealousy. Jealousy only finds expression in a fearful man. What is jealousy? Some are jealous that another man will steal their wife from them, will snatch their wife. So they follow the wife, they monitor the wife everywhere the woman goes to. If it's the woman, monitors the man, checks the man's phone every time. That is fear. Fear leads to jealousy. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. Fear can make one sorrowful. Fear can lead to sorrow, because the Bible talks about this,
a sorrowful spirit. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Fear finds expression in a lying spirit. Fear of what will happen if I tell the truth. Fear of what will happen if I tell the truth. That is the main reason why a lot of people lie. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Fear of losing your job will make you lie. Fear of losing that big contract will make a lot of people to lie. Mm-hmm. What does fear do? Quickly, what does fear do? What effect does it have? Keeps one in bondage. Fear keeps people in bondage, keeps one under bondage. The fear of more work. Remember that story in Exodus chapter 6. Fear of more work and severe punishment made the children of Israel in Egypt not to listen to Moses. If you go, you can read that Bible passage, Exodus chapter 6. They told Moses in verse 9. So Moses spoke. Moses spoke thus to the children of Israel, but they did not heed Moses because of anguish of spirit and cruel bondage. Because the first time he went to Pharaoh, Pharaoh doubled the affliction. So this second time now, when he said he was going again, they said no. After I told them that this is what the Lord has promised, this is where the Lord is taking you. Verse 9, they still said, Moses spoke thus to the children of Israel. And then the Bible says, but they did not heed Moses, they did not listen to Moses because of anguish of spirit and cruel bondage. Fear keeps one under bondage. Fear gives anxiety. Fear graduates to anxiety. Anxiety comes from anticipating trouble. It's just the anticipation of you are not even in the trouble yet, but you are anticipating it. That is fear. And the next step is that that fear leads to anxiety. What we talk about that the signal to the brain, the chemicals that are released, and the breathing that comes that goes faster. The breathing that goes faster is anxiety. The heart that beats faster is anxiety. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Fear gives anxiety. Fear leads to anxiety. Fear is an instrument of oppression by the devil. Job chapter 3, verse 25. Job said, for the thing I greatly fear has come upon me, and what I dreaded has happened to me. A man will nurse and keep after for what he fears until they become manifested. When a man nurses and cater so much for his fear, irrational fear, a fear that affects the daily living, it becomes manifested at the end of the day. Job, if you go and look at the story of Job, the Bible said that daily, after his children, they have their parties, they have their good time, the Bible says daily he will offer sacrifices to God on their behalf, that perhaps they must have said something. His sacrifices was not to worship God. His sacrifices was the fear that he has that something evil will happen to those children. And at the end of the day, what he feared most happened to him. I pray for somebody listening to me this morning. Whatever is the fear that you have, it has not happened to you yet, but you are fearful of it. It will not happen to you in the mighty name
Amen.
Of Jesus. Amen! Some of us, we fear death. I pray for you this morning that you will live, that you will not die,
Amen.
That you will live to declare the glory of the Lord in the land of the living.
Amen!
In Jesus' name.
Amen!
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah!
Goliath used fear as a weapon of oppression against the children of Israel until God delivered them through David.
Mm-hmm.
So fear can lead to oppression. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Fear makes you forget all that God has done for you. Fear will make a man, even that story of Goliath and David, the children of Israel forgot completely They became so fearful that they forgot completely what the Lord has done for them. The Lord that parted the Red Sea. The Lord that delivered them from Pharaoh. The Lord that saved them for 400 years of servitude. They forgot all about that. Just a man, a mere man, stood before them. And the Bible says they were so fearful until God sent deliverance. God will send deliverance to someone listening to me this morning in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever you fear will not turn to reality, will not come to manifestation in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Fear can cause a delay in destiny. Fear can cause a delay in destiny. Fear of failure will not allow a man to succeed. Because you fear, you are so fearful of failing, you will not even go and write that exam. Because you are so fearful of failing, you will not even go and apply for that job. Because you are so fearful of failing, you will not even go and try out for that position. I'm praying for you this morning. The power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead will deliver you from every of your fear in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In that Bible passage that we read, we're going back to, again to the 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7. There were three ways, three things that the Lord has given to us to be able to deal with this oppressive spirit, the spirit of fear. It takes three dimensions of the Spirit of God to conquer fear. For God has not given us a spirit of fear. What has He given us? Spirit of power, spirit of love, and a spirit of sound mind. It is for you not to take what the enemy is offering. What the enemy is offering, because the Bible says, for God has not given us, God has not offered that spirit to any of us. What the Lord is offering to us is the spirit of power, spirit of love, and the spirit of sound mind. So it is for you to reject the spirit of fear. It is for you to accept from the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords Himself the spirit of power, the spirit of love, and the spirit of sound mind. It takes power, it takes love, it takes a sound mind to conquer fear. Fear can only manifest or find expression when we lack power, when we lack love, when we lack a sound mind. We're going to take them one by one. We're going to take power first. There is a direct relationship between fear and weakness. Weakness is associated with fear. Anytime a man fails to recognize that he's a carrier of the power of God, fear find expression in such a man. Let me repeat that again. When a man fails to recognize, when a Christian, a child of God, not just any man really, so don't let me just say when a man, any child of God that fails to recognize that he is a carrier of the power of God, fear finds expression in that man. We fear, whatever you fear, whatever is the fear that you have that fear because you know your weakness. For example, when they ask you to come and speak in front of a crowd, and you know that you have never done it before, that becomes a fear for you. Because you are aware of your weakness. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But the day that you speak in front of the crowd and you understand and you realize that I can do this, you become empowered.
Hallelujah.
You know, the next time they call you, you now know that you are not weak in that area anymore. I hope you are getting this. I hope you understand this.
Yes, sir.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We fear our enemies. or our challenges because we know our weaknesses. What most people don't know is how much God has put into them. God has all the power that we need to overcome, and he has promised us his presence. He is Emmanuel, God with us. Revelation 21, 3. Revelation chapter 21, verse 3. He says, behold, Revelation 21, 3. Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. God himself will be with them and be their God. That is his promise. Praise the name of the Lord. Let's also go to 2 Corinthians 12, 9. His tabernacle is with men, and he will dwell among us. And we will be his people, and he himself will be among us. 2 Corinthians 12, 9 says, my grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. My strength is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, most gladly, I will rather boast in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. The power of Christ is resting upon you once you are a child of God. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You don't have to be afraid, because God has all the power that you need. Your personal ability cannot do anything. And that is understandable, that your personal power, you cannot do anything by your own. But with God, nothing shall be impossible. Psalm 62, verse 11 says, God has spoken once. Twice have I heard this, that power belongs to God.
Amen.
We have the power, not in ourselves, but in God who lives within us by his Spirit. It is him who lives within us by his Spirit. We operate through the power that he has, not of our own power. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I can do all things through Christ who emboldens me. I can do all things through Christ who empowers me. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. So you need not be afraid if Christ lives in you. Praise the name of the Lord. Mm-hmm. Quickly, we are going to love. We are going to love. This is agape love. The love that comes from giving of oneself to others. The love that comes from giving of yourself to others. We are afraid because we do not love enough. You are scared because you do not love enough. 1 John chapter 4, verse 18. 1 John chapter 4, verse 18 says, there is no fear in love. 1 John 4, 18. 1 John 4, 18. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, because fear involves torment. But he who fears has not been made perfect in love. We love him because he first loved us. He who fears have not been made perfect in love. He who fears have not been made perfect in love. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
John 13:14. John 13:14 says, love one another as I have loved you. And Christ is not just saying, just one another, as you love your child, as you love your wife, as you love just those that you love. He's saying there also, love every man. Mark 12:31, love your neighbor as yourself. And not just your near neighbor, not just the man close to you, the man, your next door neighbor, not just your good neighbor. Love your neighbor as yourself. Love your enemy also. Luke chapter 6, verse 27. The Bible says, Jesus Christ also says, love your enemy. Agape love is unconditional love. The love exhibited by Jesus, the love that took Jesus to the cross to die for mankind. We spend too much time fearing and hating each other. We fear what that man will do. Like I said before, that is the fear that drives a lot of people to the herbalist, to the wizard, to the witches. We fear each other so much, we use our time to hate each other so much. We spend too much time consuming information that will make us fearful. The more news we listen to, the more fearful we become. We should spend our time, especially this lockdown period, we should spend much more of our time praying for the world, praying for our neighbors, expressing our love to each other. The Bible says, love casts out fear. God has given to you the spirit of love. Weekly, we're going to sound mind. If you are taking notes, sound mind means sound thinking. It means wisdom. It means good judgment. Refrain from bad, unhealthy thinking. Refrain from it. As a man thinking is that, so he is. Proverbs 23:7. What you think, when you keep thinking about it, when you keep pondering on it, becomes reality. Fear rules in a heart that is full of bad and negative thoughts. A sound mind will seek for information about the coronavirus and will not listen to what the politicians and the news media are feeding us. All they are dishing out to us is their opinion clouded with personal interest. When one doesn't have the right information about something, it creates fear. When you do not have the right information, it creates fear. Replace your fear with faith this morning. Paul in 2 Corinthians 1:7 says, our hope for you is steadfast. Steadfast means firm. Because we know that you are partakers of the sufferings, so also you will partake of the consolation. As many as are partaking of the suffering now, there is going to be a light at the end of the tunnel. Stop being fearful. The Lord that has kept you so far, the Lord that has preserved you so far, the Lord that has been with you, that you are not dead right now, you will not die in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will be a partaker of the consolation. What is Paul saying here? Why is his hope firm? Why is his hope steadfast? His hope is firm because of the information he has. He said, because we know. If you read that Bible passage again, 2 Corinthians 1:7, our hope for you is steadfast because we know information is power. Knowledge is power. What we know is what usually gets us through difficult situations. Fear will not get us through any difficult situation. Fear of the coronavirus will not get us through the coronavirus. Praise the name of the Lord. The knowledge that I have of the promises of God saw myself and my wife through the time we were trusting the Lord for the fruit of the womb. What we knew, the information that we had there gave us hope and confidence and not fear. Replace your fear with faith this morning. Get the facts about what you are going through. What is it that you are going through? They have told you that you have this condition. Read about it. Get the facts about it. Don't listen to people. And not just every fact. Don't go on Facebook and read what people are saying about it. Go to the library. Don't even go on the internet, because half of 90% of the information on the internet are falsehood. Understand something. Understand that not everything you hear is the truth. Not everything that you hear is the truth. Not everything that you hear from the president is the truth. Not everything that you hear from your governor, not just because they're in that position, does not make it the truth. Your pastor will try to tell you the truth. But sometimes it's also clouded by the side that your pastor is on. We are all human beings. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Not everything you hear is the truth. Proverbs chapter 14, verse 15. Proverbs 14, 15 says, the simple believes every word. Proverbs 14, 15. When they say somebody is simple, somebody help me. What's the meaning of when they say somebody is simple?
Gullible.
The person is gullible. The simple believes every word, but the prudent considers well his steps. The second thing I want you to understand, not everyone you hear talking about your situation, about your problem, about your illness, not everyone you hear talking about COVID-19, not everyone you hear talking about coronavirus knows what they are talking about. For example, some people, they are very good at speaking about marriages. Go and ask them, they've never been married. Some people will tell you about how to raise up children. Ask them, they do not have a child. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Not everyone you hear talking about your situation knows what they are talking about. Proverbs 13:16. Proverbs 13:16 says, act with knowledge. Proverbs 13:16. Every prudent man acts with knowledge, but a fool lays open his folly. Every prudent man acts with knowledge. Everything that you're going to do, let back it up with knowledge. Back it up with the understanding of the situation that you have found yourself. It will help you. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let all your decisions be based on knowledge. I want to tell you this morning, coronavirus is not a death sentence.
Amen.
Coronavirus is not a death sentence.
Amen.
What is being reported is like one is dead already. Immediately you have that infection. What you hear in the news, if you feed yourself with what you hear in the news, what you hear is that once you have the infection, you are dead. They are not reporting the survivors. They are not reporting about the survivors. Some people are, in fact, majority of people, a whole lot of people survived this. Not everybody who contacted it dies. They are not reporting about those who are infected, but they are not showing any symptoms at all. There are some people walking about very healthy and they have it. They are not reporting the 90-year-olds that were infected and were really, really sick and survived. They are not reporting those who through all this are discovering themselves. Some people right now are discovering themselves. Some people, when this is all over, are becoming multi-millionaires. Where are you fearful? Why don't you be part of those people? And if you remain in your shell, if all you do is watch TV day in, day out, you are not praying, you are not seeking the face of the Lord, there is no way inspiration can come to you to do anything else. Mm. If all you do is occupy, preoccupy yourself with being fearful, there is no way inspiration can come. Yes, people are dying, but a whole lot is going on unreported. Refuse to be given the spirit of fear. The enemy will offer it to you. It is left for you to accept it. I don't know what you're going through personally right now. And the picture that they have painted, your issue is not even COVID-19. Your issue is personal. I don't know the picture that they have painted already. I don't know if the picture is making you so fearful. I want to let you know that if you are a child of the living God, it will pass away, because even the COVID-19 will pass away. Whatever you are going through is going to end. The word of God says, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love him. God has given you the spirit of power. He has given you the spirit of love, and he has given you the spirit of a sound mind. Accept this gift today, and your life will never be the same again.
Amen.
If you are not born again, and your biggest fear, really, actually right now, should not even be a COVID-19 or the coronavirus. Your biggest fear right now will not be if the world is going to fall on your head. Your biggest fear should be where you're going to spend eternity. Your biggest fear will be where you are going when all this ends, when the heart and the heaven passes away. Where are you going to be? Where are you going to spend your eternity? That should be your biggest fear right now. Wherever you are, if you are ready to accept Christ as your Lord and Savior this morning, so that fear will not rule over you anymore. So that fear will not oppress you anymore. Wherever you are, you can just kneel down quietly, confess your sin, pray to God this morning. Confess your sin to him. Ask him, tell him that you are repenting of every of your sin. Ask him to forgive every of your sins. Pray that he will clean you of every form of unrighteousness. Accept him, say to him that I'm accepting you as my Lord, as my Savior. Pray, say to him that you are renouncing every pact with the devil. Say with all confidence that from today you are born again. My God and my King, I just pray for as many, Lord Almighty, this morning are yielding to this call. Father, Lord God, that they won't fear to be a thing of the past in their life. Father, Lord God, please accept them, Lord Almighty, as they are yielding to this call this morning, King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, as they are running to the feet of the cross. Father, please, Lord, accept them. Forgive their sins, Lord Almighty. Write their names parallelly in the book of life. Thank you, Most High God. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Praise the name of the Lord. If you have given your life to Christ this morning, I welcome you. I welcome you into the family of Christ. I pray that you will never go back again in the name of Jesus. I pray that the Lord himself will write your name permanently in the book of life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray that every pact that you have with the enemy is broken from today in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want to encourage you to find a church believing, a Christ believing church rather, a Christ believing church. And once this is all over, find a Christ believing church to join, and the Lord himself will build you up spiritually in the mighty name of Jesus. I want you to pray. I want you to pray for yourself wherever you are this morning. That I reject every, if you are born again, if you are a child of God already, pray for yourself. Father, I reject the spirit of fear from today in Jesus' name. I reject the spirit of fear. I reject the spirit of fear from today in the name of Jesus. Talk to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Father, I reject the spirit of fear. I have no pact with the spirit of fear anymore. I accept in the mighty name of Jesus, I accept the spirit of power. I accept the spirit of love. I accept the spirit of sound mind. Thank you, Most High God. Blessed be your holy name, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Father in heaven, King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, we want to thank you, Most High, for this morning. Thank you, Lord, for speaking to us again. The Lord Almighty, you have not given us the spirit of fear, but the spirit of power, the spirit of love, and the spirit of sound mind. Father, Lord God, we accept all this gift this morning in the name of Jesus. From today, Lord Almighty, we confront every fear that is making us useless, that is not making us achieve that which you, Lord, want us to achieve. We confront those fear today. We say they become powerless in the name of Jesus. We say that they release every of their hold on us in the mighty name of Jesus. Father in heaven, we thank you. We honor your wonderful name. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.